Hello and welcome to the MATLAB and Simulink Racing Launch. In this video, we'll show how to implement a pure pursuit controller on a vehicle for path tracking. We'll see how you can build a vehicle path tracking model in Simulink and visualize the motion in various environments. We'll go through some of the basics of the pure pursuit controller. Then we'll have a section for implementation using Simulink. And finally, we'll go through the key takeaways. So now let's get started. The pure pursuit controller is a path tracking algorithm where we place a waypoint or a reference point on a path at a fixed distance ahead, which is also called lookahead distance of the vehicle, and calculate the steering command to intersect with this point. As the vehicle turns towards the reference path, the point continues to move forward, reducing the steering angle and slowly bringing the vehicle on the path. The lookahead distance is the main tuning property of the controller. The figure shows the effect of look-ahead distance on a vehicle motion. For smaller look-ahead distance, the path is oscillatory and accurate, and for a larger look-ahead distance, the path is less oscillatory, but the tracking is poor. Further, this is a formula for calculating the wheel steering angle, where L is the bicycle length, LD is the look-ahead distance, and alpha is the target direction angle. And the same can be also seen in the figure. Moving ahead, here are the steps involved in implementing the pure pursuit controller using Simulink. As a first step, we generate the waypoints or reference points, then we build the model in Simulink, and finally, we visualize the vehicle motion in various environments such as 2D, 3D, and bird's eye scope. So now let's switch to MATLAB and check out these steps in detail. To generate the waypoints, we use the driving scenario designer where we have defined the road and added the waypoints for the vehicle to move with a constant velocity. For more information on various other capabilities of driving scenario designer, please check out the links provided in the description. Further, this scene is saved as a MAT file that contains data for the reference path. To extract the data, we have created a script where we can see these are the commands to define the reference path. Further, the script also contains data for defining the reference simulation time, vehicle parameters, and the controller's initial tuning parameters. Once we have these reference points and initial parameters set, let's check out how we have built the model in Simulink. To the Simulink blank canvas, we bring in a vehicle body 3D of dual track block from the vehicle dynamics blockset, and then define certain initial values to implement a vehicle body model. Next, we define the reference path in X and Y directions. To implement the pure pursuit controller, we use the pure pursuit block from the Robotics system toolbox, where we define the look-ahead distance and check the target direction to output the target angle. As the input waypoint port accepts the signal in the form of an n×2 array, we convert the reference signal using a concatenate block. Next, we extract the vehicle current pose from the vehicle 3D of dual track block using a bus selector and use a mux signal to convert these into a vector accepted by the pose input port. Further, we use some basic blocks to formulate the wheel steering angle referring to the formula shown earlier. Here, alpha is the target direction angle that is provided by the pure pursuit block, and then we connect the formulated wheel steering angle to the vehicle block using a concatenate block to complete the model. Please note that as an alternative, we can also connect the output linear velocity port of the pure pursuit block to move the vehicle with a constant velocity. However, since in later models, we'll be adding some more dynamics and a longitudinal controller, we'll stick with a constant block to define the velocity. To learn more about implementing pure pursuit controller for a differential drive robot, please check the links in the description. In short, this was a procedure to show how you can easily connect blocks to build a model in Simulink. Now we have restructured the same model where we have included the wheel steering angle formulation in a subsystem and added a mask to define the bicycle length and look-ahead distance. Further, we have added a 2D visualization block and cleaned the model using some subsystems. So let's run the model and check the results. As we can see, with the correct selection of the look-ahead distance, the vehicle is successfully able to track the reference path. We can also visualize the steering angle, which is variable within the limits of passenger vehicles. Now let's check out the effect of changing the look-ahead distance. As we decrease the look-ahead distance, the vehicle does track the path, but the path is oscillatory. Whereas, increasing the look-ahead distance removes the oscillatory motion, but on the cost of poor tracking. Hence, the look-ahead distance should be selected properly to keep a balance between the tracking and the stability of the vehicle. Now let's increase the velocity and see the effect on the vehicle motion. So we increase the velocity to 15 meters per second and we see lower precision tracking at the turns. Now one way to improve the tracking could be to reduce the velocity at the turns and add a longitudinal controller to track the reference velocity. So let's check out that model. Hence, we move ahead to our next model where we add more dynamics and a longitudinal controller. Compared to the last model, in this model, we have added a simplified block for powertrain and drivetrain. For this, we have referred to the scene interrogation reference application. To know more about this, please go through the video description where we have provided the link. In the controller subsystem, we have added a longitudinal driver to track the reference velocity. The block takes in the reference velocity, longitudinal vehicle velocity, and grade as input signals and outputs acceleration and deceleration command based on the type of controller and selected tuned control parameters. Next, we have divided the velocity into different regions, for example, lower velocity at turns, and have built a lookup table which looks like this, and this block calculates the velocity in that region based on x and y coordinates. Apart from that, there is no major change in the model. Now let's run the simulation, and as we can see that now we have much better tracking at the turns because of the longitudinal controller. Having seen the model with the longitudinal and lateral controller at higher velocity, let's run the vehicle through a city scene. So for that, we use the driving scenario designer to generate the reference points. However, rather than creating the scene from the scratch, we use the pre-built scenarios where we can see various pre-built scenes. Here, we select the US city block scene, and when we select this, the scene can be visualized in the scenario canvas with various actors. So to this scene, we have already added the vehicle and defined the waypoints to move the vehicle without colliding with any of the obstacles. Now we have built a new model referring to the previous models we are following at the modifications. The waypoint subsystem contains the data for the US city scene. Then we have changed the lookup table for the velocity where we have divided the velocity into 5 regions. We start with 12 meters per second and during turns the velocity reduces to 5 meters per second, and similarly we have different velocity in different regions. Finally, we have added some additional blocks for visualization. The simulation 3D vehicle with ground following block implements the vehicle in a 3D visualization environment where we need to define the vehicle parameters. Further, simulation 3D scene configuration block configures a 3D simulation environment where we can select the scene source and scene name. For this model, as we have extracted the reference points from the US city scene in the driving scenario designer, we'll select the same scene to visualize the vehicle motion in the 3D environment. Having configured the 3D scene, now let's run the simulation. As we can see, the vehicle is successfully tracking the reference path without colliding with any of the obstacles. Now, to visualize the path in a bird's eye scope, we have added a subsystem where the MATLAB function packs the ego information into a single ego actor bus, and the driving scenario reader block reads the scenario file. To activate the bird's eye scope, we click on the tab here, which shows a blank scope canvas with no signals. To see the signals, click Find Signals. The scope updates a block diagram and automatically finds the signals in the model. So once again, when we run the simulation, we can visualize the vehicle motion in bird's eye scope, where the vehicle is successfully tracking the reference path without colliding with any of the actors. So this was our final model, where we saw how we can drive the vehicle through a pre-built scene using a pure pursuit and a longitudinal controller. In case you are interested to learn about other controllers such as Stanley and MPC, please check out the links in the description. Now let's move ahead and check out the key takeaways. As we saw, the look-ahead distance is the main tuning property of the pure pursuit controller. That is, the way we tune the look-ahead distance will affect the vehicle motion. then at higher velocities and varying curvatures, combining lateral and longitudinal controllers give better path tracking results. And finally, MATLAB and Simlink provide various algorithms and tools for generating waypoints, building vehicle and controller models, and visualizing the vehicle motion in various environments. And as usual, these are the Racing Launch resources. If you have any queries, reach out to racinglaunch@mathworks.com. And we would also encourage you to join our Facebook group to check out the latest updates. And also check out our student tutorials and Racing Launch blog. Thank you.